So yes, one of the sessions I gave here at EHA was about mechanisms of resistance to immunomodulatory agents. I think this is a problem we're facing now in our patients, that they are exposed to, or we have the availability of many different agents, but at the end they all develop resistance to these agents. And I think it's very important to understand what are the mechanisms of the resistance to each of them, because each of the drugs has its own mechanisms to try to overcome and to target them. In this regard, for IMiDs, one important question is how they work, because for PIs, we know they inhibit the proteasome, for the acetylase inhibitor, the acetylases, for monoclonal antibodies, different antigens, but the IMiDs, it's not so clear. It was not clear, and in fact, until 2010, when cereblon was described as the target for IMiDs, so cereblon under all the pathway, which is cereblon is an E3 ubiquitin ligase complex, and through this targeting this, ubiquitinates some proteins that become degraded by the proteasome. So we know that this is the main mechanism of action of IMiDs, and we know that some abnormalities in this pathway, such as a decrease in cereblon, is one of the key mechanisms for resistance. And we know that most of the patients that develop resistance, and also cell lines in the preclinical setting, they have low levels of cereblon. So cereblon is key for the development of resistance, of the activity of these drugs and the development of the resistance. Also, there have been some reports on mutations on cereblon, and we can say that there are some mutations, and this will be important in some patients, but this is not probably the key or the most important mechanism for the broad amount of patients in multiple myeloma. Finally, apart from these cereblon-mediated mechanisms, there are other cereblon-independent mechanisms. And we know from our preclinical data and others, we have shown that there is an upregulation of some pathways, such as the MEK pathway, WNT pathway, STAT3 pathway, and, well, I think there are several other options and that we are exploring. But the main point here is that we don't really know how the patients develop resistance to IMiDs. We know have some clues of some of them, but probably it's independent, it's individual, and each patient has its own mechanism. But I think it's very important to explore that, then trying, as I said at the beginning, to develop some strategies trying to overcome the resistance.